what's the matter?
Hello, Professor. How are you feeling this evening?
I'm feeling fine, only I'm full of soup.
Oh, you're feeling fine, only you're full of soup. Then you must be feeling super fine.
Jokes, yes?
Say, Professor, I'm going to try and tell you a few jokes I told with the minstrel show. And I warn you, these jokes are very bad. So in order that you can tell when a joke arrives, I will rattle my bones thusly. That will let you know that I have told a joke. Now for the first joke. Carrie Nation says the morning we'll awake and find we have a woman president. Great. Can you picture a female president? Can you picture Congress full of women? Can you picture every seat in the U.S. Senate occupied by a woman and only one speaker in the House? And yet they keep on howling for women's rights. I have no use for women's rights. I married a big woman. I got all the rights and lefts and uppercuts and half Nelsons I could use. There's another joke. You know, I do not think the young ladies nowadays treat the young men right anyhow. I think when a young lady takes a young man away from a happy home and a mother's care, she should be morally certain she's competent to support him in the style and luxury that he's been used to. They can't support a husband and have no business to get married. And now they tell us that Teddy is going hunting, going over to Africa to shoot the African lion. But he hasn't got us beaten any. We can stay over here and shoot the lion, the dandelion. There's another joke. But don't you know that every traveler likes to talk about something he's least familiar with? So I will talk about Pullman cars. But did you ever notice the rules the Pullman company hand to their porters? Here they are. Take notice that the sleeper, it is always under your keeping. Also are the sleepers when the sleepers, they are peacefully sleeping. The car you must go through and see it hasn't any broken panes. Then go through the passengers and relieve them of their chains. But strange as it may seem, last night I was in a Pullman sleeper. And when I awoke this morning, across the aisle from me, a little baby also awoke and started to cry lustlessly. It started to cry. Well, anyhow, the baby started to cry. And just as the baby started to cry, the fresh porter opened the door and yelled, "First call for breakfast!" Now I guess I'll sing. I feel it coming over me. I'll try and tell a story. Very often it's been told. There's a woman in the cave. The adage is a good one, but it's very, very old. There's a woman in the cave. Why did Adam bite the apple? Who left Moses in the night? Samson get his hair cut? Who made Cain and Abel fight? I know what the Bible teaches, but I'll gamble I am right. There were women in the cave. You know, that happened a great many years ago. Now I'm going to try and tell you what happened to me in regards to the woman in the cave. One time I brought my wife a watch, that's how I got in bad. There's a woman in the cave. And when I gave it to her, you can bet that she was mad. There's a woman in the cave. Her watch, it was a dandy, it was 20 carat fine. And had she only seen it, she'd have thought it was divine. But when I gave it to her, by mistake I gave her mine. There's a woman in the cave. Now there's a chestnut that needs a roasting. Don't carry in your pocket, boys, another woman's face. Your wife may find it. You'll get a toasting. Although your girl is all the works, don't put her in the case.